The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 3rd chapter, text number 6 through 10, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 23rd, 1968, in Los Angeles.
God. One who restrains the senses and organs of action, but whose mind dwells on sense objects, certainly deludes himself and is called a pretender.
Yes. This is very important. Yoga Indriya Sangyama. Yoga, the definition of yoga means sense control, controlling the sense. So here Krishna says that you cannot control your senses artificially. It is not possible. Those who are trying, just like some of the yogis, they close their eyes, "Oh, I'll not see beautiful woman." That is another practice. But that does not mean that he can control his senses, no. You cannot curb down the natural force of sense. This is a secret. People do not know. And if you let the senses go on in its own way, that is also dangerous. Then you are going to hell. Adanta govi visatang tamishram. If your senses are not controlled, then your senses will drag you to the darkest region of hell. That is another problem. Generally, in the material world, adanta means I am controlled. Go means senses. Adanta govi, visatang tamistam, puna puna char vitachar vanana. Simply repeating, chewing the child. The whole history of the world, you just study, is a history of sense gratification. Just take for example, some 20 years ago, one Mr. Adolf Hitler came in the scene. And there was great upheaval as war in Europe and America. From 1933 to 1947 or something like that, the whole world was in trouble. But he's gone, finished. And what did he do? Sense gratification. That's all. He wanted that this way government should be, according to his own sense. Another person, just like Mr. Churchill or your President Roosevelt, they say, no, the sense gratification should not be like that. The sense gratification should be like this. So it is the war of sense gratification, that's all. One leader is presenting a program of sense gratification. Another leader is presenting another program of sense gratification, and there is class. This is going on. This is the history of the world. And another class, they are thinking, oh, there is so much trouble simply by sense gratification. Let us control our senses. Brahma Satya Jagan Mithya, just like Mayavadi philosopher, Sankaraj. They say this world is useless. This world is useless. Only Brahma, the supreme Brahma, impersonal Brahma, that is truth. That is also another sense gratification. That is bigger sense gratification. Why? These Mayavadi philosophers, they want to merge into the existence of the Supreme One. That means, by becoming Hitler, Churchill or Roosevelt, their senses were not very much satisfied. Now they say, this world is false, now let me become the Supreme. There is another sense. So this world, without Krishna consciousness, is simply sense gratification. That's all. One may present in one way, another may present in another way. But it is sense gratification. Therefore, the so-called yogis, 15 minutes meditation, or say, 15 hours meditation, or 15 months meditation, but as soon as meditation finished, sense gratification. That's all. So this sense gratification program is very strong. How? And so long you will indulge in sense gratification, the repetition of birth and death will go on. The repetition of birth, this body, Bhagavad says, these people are working for sense gratification. Nunang pramatya. Pramatya means mad after sense gratification. Kurute vikarma. And for sense gratification, they are acting so abominably that it is not to be uttered. Kurute vikarma. Jadindriya pritaya pranati. They have engaged their life in sense gratification. Na sadhu manne. This is not good. This is not good. Why? Jata. Because Atmana, this spirit soul, Atmanayam, asannapi klesa deyasa deha. This body is temporary, but so long this body is there, you will have to suffer. What is that suffering? The sum total of suffering is birth, death, old age and disease. This is due to this body. Therefore, the problem is how to stop this material body. Repetition. Today I have got this body, Indian, tomorrow I may get American, this next birth. Tomorrow means next birth. Next birth, another, next birth, another, next birth, another. It is going on. Going and there is no stoppage, this transmigration of the soul. But so long you do not stop it, there is no question of being freed from suffering. They do not know it. They are thinking they are advancing. What advancement you have made? These sufferings are there. Birth, death, old age and disease. You cannot stop it. Abrahma Bhavana Lokan, if you go to this moon planet or to the highest planet, these four things will follow. So therefore, sense gratification must be stopped. But if you want to stop it artificially, it is impossible. Neither by this yoga process, neither by this jnana process. Simply for the time being you can check, just like a naughty boy. By force you can stop him acting and mischievously. But as soon as he gets opportunity, again. Similarly, senses are very strong. You cannot stop them artificially. Therefore, the only remedy is Krishna consciousness. This voice in Krishna consciousness, this is also sense gratification, eating nice prasadam, dancing, chanting, reading philosophy, but it is in connection with Krishna. That is the significance. This Krishna consciousness movement is an art of living by which you will feel your senses are fully satisfied, but you are going to be free next life. This is the ninth process. And artificially, if you want to stop your senses, you will fail. That is Krishna says, one who retains, restrains the senses and organs of action, but whose mind dwells on sense objects. Just like Vishwamitram. There are many instances. He was a great king, and he wanted to be yogi, and he went to forest, gave up his kingdom, went to forest, and he was meditating very seriously, and Indra, king of heaven, he sent some society girls of heaven, the planet, Manaka, and she came, she began to dance before the closed-eyed yogi, and as soon as he heard, oh, there is very nice a female voice and dancing, and as soon as opened, she became captivated, embraced her. So everything gone, you see. So sense gratification, you cannot stop artificially. Nirvande Krishna Kama. Therefore, he advised our students, either boys and girls, that if you have, of course, if you are serious in Krishna consciousness, you forget all these nonsense sense gratification. But if you are disturbed, all right, get yourself married. Live peacefully, husband and wife, and both be engaged in Krishna consciousness. Gradually you'll forget both husband and wife. Don't try artificial. Artificial will never be successful. But if you can avoid it by advanced and strong Krishna consciousness, just like Haridas Thakur, but don't try to imitate Haridas Thakur. His stage was different. We cannot imitate. We can simply follow. Anukaran, anusaran. There are two Sanskrit words. One is imitation and one is following the footprints. If one tries to follow the footprints of great personalities, that is very nice. But we cannot imitate. Imitation is dangerous. Just like Lord Shiva. He drank an ocean of poison and he kept it on the throat. He did not allow it go down. Therefore his name is Nilakantha. It became bluish. His neck is blue. But if somebody imitates Lord Shiva and indulges intoxication, ganja, he'll go to hell. He is powerful. Somebody says, well, Lord Shiva is a smoker, so we can also smoke. No, you cannot imitate. You can simply follow. Just like the sun sign. The sun sign is so strong that it is absorbing the moisture of the filthy place. Contaminated place where one is passing stool and urine, but still it is sun. Because sun is so far. But if you live in that place for some time where urine and stools are thrown, then you will be contaminated immediately. Because you are not powerful. Tejasavana dosa. Those who are powerful if there is somebody do something which is very extraordinary, that is not to be imitated. You have to follow the rules and regulations. That will give you progress. Don't try to imitate. Just be in your position, try to follow the rules and regulations, and chant Hare Krishna, and gradually you'll get the result. There is no need of being hasty.
Verse number 7. On the other hand, he who controls the senses by the mind and engages his active organs in works of devotion without attachment is by far superior.
Yes, instead of artificially trying to meditate and control the senses, just engage your senses in the activities of Krishna consciousness, and gradually you will be happy. Your senses will be controlled.
Wow. Therefore, instead of becoming a priest or transcendentalist for the sake of wanton living, sense enjoyment, it is far better to remain in one's own business and execute the purpose of life, which is to get free from material bondage and enter into the kingdom of God. The Svaragati, goal of self-interest.
Sarthavati, yes.
A goal of self-interest is to reach Vishnu. The whole Varna and Ashram system is designed to help us reach this goal of life. A householder can also reach this destination by regulated service in Krishna consciousness. For self-realization, one can live a controlled life as prescribed in the Shastras and continue carrying out his business without attachment, and that will lead him gradually to the progressive path. Such a sincere person who follows this method is far better situated than the false pretender who adopts showbottle spiritualism to cheat the innocent public. A sincere sweeper in the street is far better than the charlatan meditator who works only for the sake of making a living.
Yes. My Guru Maharaj used to say that don't accept spiritual life for living. That's why we are sending the Sankirtan party. If we take it, it is very easy method for living without working. We are getting money for our livelihood. This is not wanted. If your spiritual life is for, just like there are so many professional chanters, not here in India, their business is, because people like chanting, so they have made this chanting business. Or a professional Bhagavad reader. People like reading of Bhagavad. There are many expert Bhagavad reader. They can show many caricatures just to attract people. And such people generally, they describe the Rasleela of Krishna. Because Rasleela is resembling, just like dealing between young boys and girls, so they take that part, particularly Rasleela, easy way. And just like here in America, I've seen so many persons, they're writing books on Krishna about Krishna's pastime with the gopis, as if Krishna has no other pastime. Because these things are very easily sellable, so they are writing books on that. I've seen one book written by Mr. Bhattacharya about this Krishna's dealings with the gopis. No, this is not it. You should not take Krishna's activities, Krishna consciousness, professionally for livelihood. That is dangerous. Your life should be sacrificed for Krishna. That is one. Otherwise, it shall be pretender. Yes, go on.
Verse number 8. Reform the prescribed duty, which is better than not working. A man cannot even maintain his physical body without work.
Yes. Krishna and Arjuna was talking Krishna never said, Arjuna, oh, my dear Arjuna, you are my friend, intimate friend and devotee, all life. You haven't got to fight with your, everything will be done by me. You go to Himalaya and meditate. No, he never said that. Krishna could do, Krishna could fight for Arjuna. He was all powerful. Without fighting, he could give him everything. But still, he wanted to engage him. That one should be engaged in Krishna consciousness along with his prescribed duty. That is required. Yes. Perform your prescribed duty, which is better than not working. If you cannot work in Krishna consciousness, then you better perform your prescribed duty according to Varna Ashram. Just like if you are a Brahmin, then you have to act such way. If you are a Kshatriya, you have to work in that way. But don't stop working. Krishna says that a man cannot even maintain his physical body without work. He does not say that you become Krishna conscious beggar and maintain your body in that way. No. That is not required. That service for Krishna should not be taken, should not be accepted as profession for livelihood. It should be simply for the service of the Lord. For the service of the Lord, you can collect millions of dollars. But for your livelihood, you cannot take $1 from any person. Then you will be indebted. You have to repay it. You cannot cheat others. This is very strict. Please enjoy. Simply for Krishna's satisfaction, you can take, you can beg from others. Just like, according to Vedic system, begging is allowed. Begging allows for whom? For the Brahmin, for the sannyasi, for the brahmachari. Because they collect money, beg from door to door for their benefit. Suppose the brahmachari is going to a householder's place or a storekeeper's place to give us some contribution. He is not collecting that money for his livelihood. He is quite competent to work. But if that $1 which he contributes to Krishna consciousness movement, it is good for him. At least some portion of his energy goes to Krishna. That is the philosophy. Not that somewhere or other I may collect some money and live very comfortably. No, you cannot do that. But you can accept Krishna's prasadam. That is a different thing. But for personal comfort, you have to work. If you are a karmi, then you have to work. If you are a devotee, if you are completely devotee means Rishikena Rishikesa Sevanam Bhakti Richam. A devotee means one who has engaged his senses 10% for the service of the Lord. He is devotee, pure devotee. So one who cannot become 10% or like become 50%, 25%, 1%, give something for Krishna. Don't be miser, because whatever you have got, it is Krishna's. So long you catch it up, it is mine, that is Maya. You just let loose it for Krishna, then it is freedom for you.
Verse number 9. Work done as a sacrifice for Vishnu has to be performed. Otherwise, work binds one of this material world. Therefore, O son of Kunti, perform prescribed duties for his satisfaction. And in that way, you will always remain unattached and free from bondage.
Yes. Bondage means working for one's own account. The same example. Just like a soldier is fighting for the country under the command of the commander-in-chief, the more he's killing, he's getting promotion, he's getting medal. But the same man, when he comes back at home, if he kills one man, his hand. Why? because the that killing and this killing is not the same thing. So, one who cannot engage himself sense-person in Krishna consciousness, let him remain in his own position and try to sacrifice for Vishnu or Krishna as far as possible. The prescription is for the grihasthas, for the householder, as exemplified by Srila Rupa Goswami, that his income was divided into four parts. 50% for Krishna, 25% for the family, and 25% for his personal reserve fund. That is, that he showed as an example how a grihastha should live. Not that out of $100, 99% for my wife and 1% for Krishna. No, not like that. He wants to sacrifice at least 50%. If he cannot sacrifice this, brahmacharis, sannyasis, they are sacrificed their everything, 10%. The grihastha, they cannot do that because they have got wife, children. Therefore, 50%. So, these are the prescribed rules and regulations for executing Krishna consciousness. Anyway, if one cannot sacrifice 10%, let him sacrifice at least 1%, 2%. The more he does, that is, more he becomes free from bondage. And the more he uses his earning for sense gratification, the more he becomes bound by the laws of the spirit. Yes.
Therefore, since one has to work even for the simple maintenance of the body, to ascribe duties for a particular social position and quality are so made that that purpose can be fulfilled. Gajana means Lord Vishnu or sacrificial performances. All sacrificial performances are meant for the satisfaction of Lord Vishnu. The Vedas enjoin Gajana via Vishnu. In other words, the same purpose is served whether you perform prescribed jhajanas or directly serve Lord Vishnu. Krishna consciousness is, therefore, the performance of jhajana, as it is prescribed here in this verse. The Vanashram institution also aims at this, satisfying Lord Vishnu. Vanashrama, akarata,
acharata, purushena, parathuma, Vishnu aradhate. By following the prescribed duties of a particular section of society in pursuance of the instruction of the Shastra means satisfaction of Vishnu. Yes.
Therefore, one has to work for the satisfaction of Vishnu. Any other work done in this material world will be a cause of bondage, for both good and evil work have their reactions, and any reaction binds the performer. One has only to work in Krishna consciousness to satisfy Krishna or Vishnu. And while performing such activities, one is supposed to be in a liberated stage. This is the great art of doing work, and in the beginning, this process requires very good and expert guidance.
Yes.
One should, therefore, act very diligently under the expert guidance of a devotee of Lord Krishna, or under the direct instruction of Krishna, under whom Arjuna had the opportunity to work. Nothing should be performed for sense gratification, but everything should be done for the satisfaction of Krishna. This practice will not only save one from the reactions of work, but will also gradually rise one to the platform of the transcendental loving service of the Lord, which alone can uplift one to the kingdom of God. Verse number 10. In the beginning of creation, the Lord of all creatures sent forth generations of men and demigods, along with sacrifices for Vishnu, and blessed them by saying, "Be thou happy by this yajna, sacrifice, because its performance will bestow upon you all desirable things.
Yes. In the creation, after creation, the yoga was also created, and everyone, created being, was ordered to perform the yoga. One cannot yogodana tapakriya natajyam. In the Bhagavad Gita also you'll find that you may be a renouncer. Sannyasi. Renouncer. You have renounced this world. But the four things, yoga. Yoga means working for satisfaction of Vishnu. Yoga. Dana. Charity. Yoga dana. Tapa. Tapa means austerity. Following the rules and regulations for spiritual attainment. These things are not to be renounced. If somebody says, oh, I have renounced the world, that does not mean you can renounce the service of the Lord. No. Even if you are sannyasi, or you have to work for Krishna. Either you are a sannyasi, or you are a householder, or brahmachari, you have to work for Krishna. But the advantage of sannyasi is that because he has no encumbrances behind, he is detached from family relationship, he has full-time service for Krishna. Similarly, brahmachari, one who is not married, simply working under the order of the spiritual master, he has also 7% time to work. These are the secrets that one has to work for Krishna. Either he is a brahmachari or sannyasi, it doesn't matter. Householder. Otherwise, he will be captured by Maya. Gone.
Therefore, the material creation by the Lord of creatures, Vishnu, is a sort of chance offered to the conditioned souls to come back to home, back to Godhead.
Yes, this material creation, you will find in the Bhagavad Gita that just like our body, his body is created at a certain period by the father and mother, and it remains for some time, it grows, it gives some byproduct, then it dwindles, then vanishes. Yes, you can study from it. Similarly, the whole cosmic manifestation, this is a huge body. So it has a time of creation, its development, its byproduct, its activities, then dwindling, then it will also vanish. It will also vanish. And why this creation is there? This creation is there because those who have rebelled against God, Krishna, they are not allowed to enter into the kingdom of God. They are kept aloof, and this creation is made just to give them chance to develop Krishna consciousness. The Vedic Shastras are there, the representative of Krishna's are there, they are teaching, my dear conditioned soul, please adopt this means and end your reputation of birth and death, come to the kingdom of God. This is a chance. But if somebody takes it, or now I have got my body, let me enjoy my senses to the fullest extent. Then he is doomed. Then he loses the chance. Therefore, this human form of body should not be wasted simply by sense gratification like cats and dogs. Those who do not know what is the complication of this material nature, this spiritual life or material life, they are rascals, simply they are enjoying the senses which have been given by laws of nature. They are thinking the best things we have got, let us enjoy to the fullest extent. No, it is not good. You must take the advantage to get out of this field of material activities and enter into the kingdom of God. This is a chance of creation.
All the entities within the material creation are conditioned by material nature because of their forgetfulness of their relationship to Vishnu or Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God. The Vedic principles are to help us understand this eternal relationship. The Lord says that the purport of the Vedas is to understand Him.
Yes. That we'll find in the 15th chapter. Vedashta sarvai aham eva veda. What is the purpose of so many scriptures and Vedic literature? Just to give you information that there is Krishna and you are eternally related with Krishna, you have forgotten, just revive that relationship and perfect your life. That is the sum and substance of all Vedic literature.
In the Vedic hymns, it is said,
Patim visvasra atma isaram. Yes, God.
The Lord of the living entities is the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Yes, Lord of the living entities. Just like here we have got a leader, a society leader or a party leader or a club leader. There are leaders. Some are led by somebody, some are led by somebody, we don't wish to discuss, but there is a leader. That without leader, nobody goes to hell, neither to heaven. There must be one leader. The supreme leader is Krishna. Leader of the leader. There are various types of leaders. Nitya nityanam chetanas chetananam eka bhunam vidadhati kaman. These are the wordings in the Vedas. So he is the supreme leader. We are following some leader. Some leader is following Stalin, somebody is Hitler, some leader is following Gandhi, somebody is following somebody. There must be some leader. But why not the supreme leader who will never misguide you? He'll give you actual path of happiness. Then you become happy. Krishna therefore says, Sarvadhanman Paritajya. You give up all nonsense leadership. Simply come unto me, surrender unto me, I give you protection. That is what. Yes. We are following leader. There is no doubt about it. But there is misleader. Andhajathanda irupaniyamana. Just like a blind man is leading other blind men. Now what is the use of such following leaders? He is blind and I am blind. So if he leads me to cross the road, then what my life? My life is a danger. So don't follow this misleader. Krishna is approved leader. All leaders of the society, any part of the world has accepted Krishna as the supreme leader. Follow him. Then he'll be happy.
Vishnu is the Lord of all living creatures, all worlds, and all futures, and protector of everything. The Lord created this material world for the conditioned souls to learn how to perform yajnas for the satisfaction of Vishnu, so that while in the material world, they can live very comfortably without anxiety in life. Then after finishing the present material body, they can enter into the kingdom of God. That is the whole program for the conditioned souls. By performance of yajna, the conditioned souls gradually become Krishna conscious and become godly in all respects. In this age of Kali, the Sankirtan yajna, or chanting the holy names of God, is recommended by the Vedic scriptures. And this transcendental system was introduced by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu for deliverance of all men. Sankirtan, yajna, and Krishna consciousness go well together. Lord Krishna, in his devotional form as Lord Chaitanya, is worshipped in the Srimad Bhagavatam as follows, with special reference to the Sankirtan yajna. In this age of Kali, people who are endowed with sufficient brain substance will worship the Lord, who is accompanied by his associates, by performance of Sankirtan yajna.
Yes, there is a verse. Jaggai sankirtanai prai jajanti hi sumedha. Those who are intelligent class of men in this age, they will worship this form of the Lord, who Krishna Vannam Tisakrishnam Sangapanga Sapartana. The Lord who is chanting always Krishna, but his body is not black. Fair complexion. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sangapanga Sapartanam, followed by many devotees. Just like you'll see the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's picture, he's followed always by his associates and devotees. Sangapanga Sapartanam. Jagganishan, this form of the Lord should be worshipped. Therefore, we do not worship Krishna directly through Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, through Sankirtan movement. That is the process prescribed in the Shastra. We cannot worship Krishna directly, then we will misunderstand. Those who are not following the path of Chaitanya Sankirtan movement, if they want to understand Krishna, they will simply misrepresent Krishna as this Rasalila and this one. That's all. No.
Although other yachanas prescribed in the Vedic literature are not easy to perform in this age of Kali, the Sankirtan yajana is the easiest and is sublime for all purposes, as is recommended in the Bhagavad Gita.
Yes, in the Bhagavad Gita also it is recommended. Satatam kirtanitam mam jatantasya dhirabhrata. So, this process, chanting of Hare Krishna mantra and gradually to develop Krishna consciousness, is the only means for, elevating yourself to the perfectional stage which is meant for this human life. Otherwise, we are simply cutting our own throat. That's all. Thank you. Any questions? Don't go to outside today's lecture. It's right one question means the lecture on which I was speaking. If there is any difficulty, that should be questioned. Otherwise, if you go outside, that is present atmosphere created for this purpose, that will be enough. So question means on the subject matter which is already discussed. If there is any doubt or if there is any difficulty for understanding the subject matter which we have already discussed, that is the subject matter of question. Yes. Krishna, directly, yes, through the process, just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself. So the Shastra advises, instructs us that those who are intelligent, the word is used there, Sumedhasa. Sumedhasa means those who have got nice brain substance. So, Krishna, you can approach Krishna. There are so many ways you can approach Krishna. In other words, it is said, Momo Bhartyanuvartanti Partha Manusya Sarvas. Krishna, our relationship is with Krishna. And that relationship cannot be cut off. That is there. Even those who are disobedient to Krishna, those who are atheist, godless, or Krishna-less, they are also obeying Krishna's order. They are also. Just like an outlaw who does not care to abide by the laws, he is also abiding the laws of the state in a different way. He is being forced. So, those who are not in Krishna consciousness, he is being forced by Maya to act. So that is there already, direct connection is there, in this way or that way. But here it is prescribed that anyone who wants the ultimate perfection of life, they should worship Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is, that's like Rupa Goswami worship Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Namo Mahavadanaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine Gauratise Namah. He says that, my Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you are the most munificent incarnation because you are distributing love of Krishna. Therefore, I offer you my respectful obeisances on account of your distributing Krishna consciousness. And this is possible because you are Krishna yourself. Krishnaya, Krishna Chaitanya Namine. Simply you have assumed the name of Krishna Chaitanya. So, these are the injunction of the Shastras, and if we follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, gives you the easiest method. He says that in this age, simply chant Krishna and you will get all perfection. So that is the easiest process. So therefore, if you follow the footprints of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then it becomes easier. Krishna says, sarva-dhanman parityajya, in the Bhagavad Gita. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, all right, you cannot give up all of a sudden everything. You just join in this chanting. That is more magnanimous, you see. We ask nobody that you fulfill all conditions of Krishna consciousness, then you come here. No. We simply say, please come here. We have taken this nice hall and these boys, they are giving their blood to maintain the establishment. We don't want anything from you. Please come and chant with us. That is our request. We don't ask you that because we are paying $400-$500 for this building, you give us something. If you give, it is welcome. But we simply request you, please come and chant with us and dance with us and take the prasadam. That's all. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's program. Because we know that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will supply us everything. We don't depend on your contribution. But if you give, that is good for you. But our only request is that please come here. Please chant with us, dance with us. That's all. Yes.
How would it be possible for a man whose mind is clouded, to constantly chant Hare Krishna? A man is always thinking thoughts about family, friends, and country, and nation.
Yes, think of, but at the same time chant. Two things will go on, and this will conquer. As Maya is forcing you to drag you from this Krishna consciousness, you also force Maya by chanting Hare Krishna. There is fight. And Maya will go away. Devi jesa agunamayam maya duratya Mami vaja prapadanti mayami tang tarantate. This maya is very strong. She will force you to entice you to other path. But if you become strong, if you chant loudly, just like Haridas Thakur was chanting, and maya could not victimize him. You know that? What was his strength? Simply chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Maya could not entice. Maya failed. Maya became his disciple. He did not become Maya's disciple. This is tug of war. So don't be afraid of Maya. Simply enhance chanting and he'll be conquered. That's all. Narayana parasarbhi na kutasana vibhuti. You are not afraid of Maya. Because Krishna is there. Yes. Krishna says, Kauntiya pratijani hi namai vaktapanastati. You just declare, my devotee will never be vanquished by Maya. Maya cannot do anything. Simply you have to become strong. And what is the strength? Chant, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Loud. Yes. Maya means which drags you from Krishna. That is Maya. Whatever form may be, force, we shall see form later on. You just like a police sends you warrant, arrest. You do not ask, what is the form of the police? But here is warrant, you have to go. Force, that's all. Similarly, don't try to understand what is Maya's form, but to just feel her force, how she is acting, how she is putting you in difficulty. You see? There are so many things. Maya puts into this difficulty and you are encumbered. That we have to understand. How I have become encumbered? In my childhood I was free. There was no encumbrances. Now I am encumbered. I am harassed. This is Maya's action. So if you want to get out of this Maya's influence, then you have to become Krishna. There is no other alternative. Chant it.